The following is a production of the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network. Ottumwa Bulldogs football is coming your way on your news and information leader, 1240 AM and 102.7 FM, KBIZ. Now, let's get you to the field with the voice of your Ottumwa Bulldogs, Jason Van Arkel.
Ottumwa High football is on the air. Good evening, everybody, from way on the western side of the metro area in Waukee. Jason Van Arkel reporting. Annie Argo, the on-site video producer. Kyle Smith is the radio producer back at the KBIZ studios. It's a blustery, cool evening up here as your Ottumwa Bulldogs get ready to take on the number 8 Waukee Northwest Wolves. Ottumwa 2-4 coming into tonight's game. Waukee Northwest is 4-2. Now, Ottumwa last week played without all three of its starting running backs. They were very shorthanded going into Ames, and the result was rather predictable. OHS does deserve credit for continuing the battle after being down 40-0 at halftime, actually outscoring the Little Cyclones 23-22 in the second half. The run game by committee did end up totaling 243 yards on the ground, and that phase will get a boost tonight as both Cam Maneri and Kobe Chantalivan return to the lineup. Also, Brandon Heminger may be ready to return as well, so the Bulldogs could get all three of their starting running backs back tonight. Maneri's return will also boost the Bulldog defense that surrendered over 500 yards of offense last week. Ottumwa is still generating turnovers. Caden Hubble snagged an interception, and Braylon Griffiths recovered a fumble last week, but OHS sorely missed Maneri in his normal middle linebacker spot. This week, they'll be missing Griffiths at outside linebacker and tight end, as he's dealing with an oblique injury, hopefully just a one-week absence for Braylon Griffiths. But even if Ottumwa was at full strength, tonight is another tough road test, facing the team that came in at number 8 in this week's Class 5A RPI rankings. That is, of course, the Waukee Northwest Wolves, their head coach, a familiar name, Corey Kopatich, in his third season, a 15-12 career record as a head coach here at Waukee Northwest. And for the second time this season, Ottumwa is facing an opposing head coach who played for and graduated from OHS. Maybe you can start calling Ottumwa the new cradle of coaches. Corey Kopatich, whose father Tom, of course, has the field at Schaefer Stadium named in his honor. Corey graduated from Ottumwa in 2002. He was most recently an assistant coach at Waukee before accepting the head job at Northwest when Waukee split into two schools before the 2021 season. The Wolves made the Class 5A playoffs in each of their first two seasons as a school and are well on their way to making it three appearances in three seasons. Their offense starts with dual-threat quarterback Sam Johnson, who has 920 passing yards and also leads Northwest with 500 rushing yards. Now, he's not very accurate. He's completed only 48% of his passes, and he's thrown 9 interceptions to his 8 touchdowns, but he still leads an attack that averages 33 points a game. More importantly, Ottumwa's had trouble stopping running quarterbacks, so look for a lot of Johnson on the ground tonight. Defensively, Northwest has given up its share of yards and points, but they also have 10 takeaways, so OHS has to do a better job of taking care of the football than they have to this point in the season. We're just getting started on the Bulldog pregame show. Right now we'll take a 3-minute timeout. Normally our second segment would be talking about previous meetings between these two schools, but we don't really have much to talk about in that area, do we? We'll explain in 3 minutes on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
All roads lead to the new home of the realtors you've come to trust in our community, Bridge City Realty. Whether you're buying or selling property, contact our qualified staff of experienced, professional salespeople at our offices, now located next door to Walgreens. We're right in the heart of Ottumwa at 301 West 4th, so stop by or call our new office line at 684-1234. Bridge City Realty, Southeast Iowa's number one real estate agency.
Looking to add value to your property? Looking for a top-rated local business? An easy way to do that is to have a fence installed. This is Jared with Pierce Fence Company. Whether you want a fence to keep your animals safe or a privacy fence to keep others out, Pierce Fence can install many different types of commercial, industrial, or residential fences. At Pierce Fence, we strive for excellence, safety, and quality. Give us a call today and find out why we lead the industry for all your fence projects in Southeast Iowa. You can count on our team here at Pierce Fence Company to get the job done right. Like us on Facebook or visit us at piercefenceco.com.
A lot of things in this world just don't make sense. Like why we drive on a parkway, but park in a driveway? It's just not logical. And when it comes to something as important as your vehicle, you need things to make sense. You can rely on Jonathan and the crew at Vice Transmission on Madison Avenue in Ottumwa. They're the logical choice for transmissions, but they also do brakes, tune-ups, mechanical repair, and more. The next time you need maintenance, transmission, or auto repairs done, contact Vice Transmission. They are more than a transmission shop.
At Gardner Collier Jewelry, our goal has always been to provide you with the very best jewelry for your money. From plain gold wedding bands to the most exquisite diamond ring, Gardner Collier has it. Our huge selection is sure to exceed your expectations, and our service is second to none. From sterling silver fashion jewelry to the one-of-a-kind diamond fashion piece, Gardner Collier can fill your jewelry desires. For the very best value in fine jewelry, choose Gardner Collier, Quincy Place Mall, Ottumwa, and Penn Central Mall, Oskaloosa.
Seasons change. Our priorities change. Your financial needs change. But there's one thing that remains consistent. Our dedication to making your financial life easier together. So let's get to know each other. Because together is better.
At Line X of Ottumwa, we know your truck is much more than a vehicle to you. Whether you use it for work or play, a Line X spray-applied bedliner is ready for the long haul. Line X provides unmatched protection with a nationwide lifetime warranty. Want more for your truck? Line X carries accessories from WeatherTech, Bach Industry, Truxedo, Truck Gear, Lux, and Luverne Truck Accessories. The right parts and accessories to make your truck, everything is possible at Line X of Ottumwa.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Ottumwa High Football on KBIZ and on the live video stream. Bulldog Football brought to you this season by Josh, Brenda, and the team at Meridian Credit Union, where it feels like home on the corner of Penn and Jeff in Ottumwa. By Bridge City Realty, your Ottumwa and surrounding area real estate pros for buying or selling property. Bridge City Realty, Southeast Iowa's trusted experts. And by Graphics Masters on Albia Road in Ottumwa, across from the BP. Contact them for all your window or auto signage, vinyl decals, wall sayings, custom apparel, and advertisement needs. Ottumwa at number 8, Waukee Northwest tonight. And normally right now we'd be talking about the last time these two teams met, but Waukee Northwest only in its third year of existence. And this will be Ottumwa's first ever meeting against the Wolves. It is also the first time that Waukee Northwest head coach Corey Kapatich has faced his former school as head coach, but not the first time he's ever coached against Ottumwa. Kapatich was on the Waukee coaching staff when the two schools met in 2018 and 2019, both of which were blowout wins for Waukee. OHS would like to avoid a similar fate here tonight, but that is a tall task on the road against a top 10 team. Nice note, in the game program tonight here at Waukee Northwest, the honorary game captain is Tom Kapatich, of course, the longtime Ottumwa head football coach who is currently spending his retirement coaching the freshman for Waukee Northwest, helping his son Corey out. Of course, Coach Kapatich has a 135-61 career record as Ottumwa's head coach with 10 playoff appearances, and the playing field at Schaefer Stadium now bears his name. So Tom Kapatich, who I got to know when I first started doing these games, he was still the Ottumwa High athletic director when I began doing Ottumwa High games. Tom Kapatich, the honorary captain here tonight for Ottumwa and Waukee Northwest. Now, the last time Ottumwa played a football game in the city of Waukee was 4 years ago when the Bulldogs traveled to take on Waukee High. It's a night that personally both Annie and I would rather forget, and not really because of what happened on the field, which was a blowout win for Waukee. The temperatures dropped rapidly that day, and with the wind howling throughout the contest, players, fans, and announcers alike were chilled to the bone by the end of the night. 4 years later, we're back in Waukee for football, and even though we're at a new school and a new stadium, the wind is still blowing. The temps are once again dropping, although not as cold as it was on that night 4 Octobers ago. And as we're doing our best to stay warm, we'll also watch to see how the conditions affect the passing game for both teams tonight. Now, we expect both teams to run the ball quite a bit anyway, but we'll see if the wind affects the play calling in any significant way.
Grant Cloutier is the son of Dave.
Going to take another three-minute timeout here on the Bulldog pregame show. When we return, we will check that out-of-town scoreboard, how the other area schools are looking tonight, who they're taking on, including one game that was last night. That comes your way next on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
This is Opula with Mike's Pizza and Steakhouse in Ottumwa. Wondering what to have for lunch or supper? You don't really want to cook? Stop in and see us. We are known for the best pizza in Southeast Iowa. Enjoy a mouthwatering steak or an awesome tenderloin. We also have salads, pasta, chicken and fish, and of course, amazing Greek food. Call ahead for carryout. Our full menu is available at mikespizzasteakhouse.com. Thank you for making us your favorite restaurant. We look forward to serving you at Mike's Pizza and Steakhouse.
Opa!
Birthdays, ladies' night out, bachelor or bachelorette party, sports team, no matter what your special event or sport, at Graphics Masters, we can make you stand out. We offer custom apparel, t-shirts, sweatshirts, koozies, and more. We even make custom signage for your event. It's all here under one roof. We even offer auto detailing as well. Like Graphics Masters on Facebook to see some of our quality work or stop into the shop located on Albee Road across from the BP. Graphics Masters, we print your words.
The secret is out. You're invited to see the all-new scoring system at Champion Bowl.
The first bowling alley in Iowa to have the new Bowler Entertainment System.
Animated and themed scoring grids and backgrounds.
It keeps score for a variety of game types.
There's classic bowling, of course, as well as Build the Monster, Bowling Hood, Battle of the Lanes, and more.
You can also video chat with any of the staff right from your bowling station.
Come experience the brand new Champion Bowl in Ottumwa,
where bowling is now awesome.
Uh-oh. Looks like it's time to bring your vehicle into Gordy's Auto on Madison Avenue. Let Steve or one of his certified mechanics diagnose your car or truck's problems and get you back on the road. Just because your car started this morning doesn't mean it's not time for a checkup. Let them change the oil or perform other preventative maintenance to keep your vehicle running smooth. Stop in and see Steve at Gordy's on Madison Avenue, just before the Rock and Roll Dairy Bar. Call for an appointment and like him on Facebook.
A-Plus Services Plumbing and HVAC takes care of your home. A-Plus Services offers multiple services under one roof. They offer residential and commercial installation of plumbing, heating, and air conditioning units in Ottumwa, Fairfield, and the surrounding areas. From new construction to replacement of your existing unit, A-Plus Services can help. Ask them about available financing options. Contact A-Plus Services for all your plumbing, heating, and air conditioning installation services. Se habla Español, your authorized local York dealer.
At Five Hogs Barbecue, our journey began with a group of folks who simply love to barbecue, a path that persists with the belief that our ribs, brisket, pulled pork, and chicken should be just as delightful to order as they are to savor. And as far as we're concerned, it's a journey with no end in sight, except the vision of a barbecue spot that's always striving to do better. Join Five Hogs Barbecue Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8 p.m. in the old Smoke and Bones building on 73rd Street in Agency. Like us on Facebook and message us to cater your next event. Come get you some goodness.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Ottumwa High football on KBIZ and on the live video stream. Bulldogs at number 8, Waukee Northwest tonight. How about the rest of the schools in our area? There was one game last night did not go very well for Van Buren. They were beaten by Columbus 61-14. Games tonight, Davis County's on the road at Mediapolis. Pekin travels to Wapello. Albee is at home to take on West Burlington. Cardinal travels to Pella Christian. Centerville welcomes Van Meter. Eddieville, Blakesburg, Fremont heading to Pleasantville tonight. Fairfield on the road at South Tama. Moravia travels to New London. Oskaloosa's got a long trip to Cedar Rapids Xavier. Sigourney Kyoto welcoming Colfax Mingo tonight. And Twin Cedars is at home. They're taking on Belle Plaine. That's the out-of-town scoreboard, the area schools in action tonight. If we happen to catch any out-of-town scores, we'll pass them along during the course of our broadcast. Right now, another three-minute timeout here on the Bulldog pregame show. When we return, we'll have the starting lineups for both teams. That comes your way next on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
It's time to choose the credit union with a new perspective. At Meridian Credit Union, we don't just see member profiles. We see people. People with goals. People who want to save more. People that we can help. That's why we offer financial services convenient to you. Great loan rates, online banking with bill pay, mobile banking, and credit cards. Join the many satisfied Meridian members today. See how our perspective can help you.
Meridian Credit Union, where it feels like home.
In Searcy, Arkansas, a young man says, "I love you" for the first time, but his girlfriend doesn't quite hear. In Franklin, Tennessee, a boy encounters his first pickle. And in Kyle, Texas, after a mission for tots, cousins realize they're a long way from Kyle, Texas. One day, many people, millions of orders. This is Howie Sonic.
Insane Motors on Madison Avenue in Ottumwa is a motorcycle and ATV store offering reasonable prices on parts and accessories. Specializing in V-twins, but also all makes and models of motorcycles, ATVs, and side-by-sides. A great gift idea, no matter the occasion, for the rider in your life. Stop in, call to order, and they can drop ship nearly anywhere. Call and speak with Alan for all your questions or to get your repairs scheduled. Insane Motors, where it's all about the ride.
Get the small town charm with real world experience at William Penn University. Located in beautiful Oskaloosa, Iowa, William Penn is the perfect place to pursue your higher education. We offer a diverse selection of majors, including a four-year nursing degree, and our state-of-the-art facilities offer the latest technology. With small class sizes and affordable tuition, William Penn is a great place to call home. Invest in your future at William Penn. Visit wmpenn.edu today to learn more and enroll.
Hey, do you have free checking that pays you? Like I should. Kasasa is free checking that pays you with real cash rewards. It's more money in your account every month you qualify. And more freedom to access ATMs anywhere. It's powerful checking for more powerful moments.
Take back banking with Iowa State Bank.
Hey guys, this is Jackie at Uncle Buck's on Church Street, Ottumwa. When folks want a great atmosphere and a wide selection on their menu, they come to Uncle Buck's. It's Ottumwa's most diverse bar and grill. Our team works tirelessly to ensure you're treated to delightful meals, refreshing drinks, and conversation. Where else can you dine more, enjoy more, and get more? Nate and I invite you to come experience Uncle Buck's for yourself. Join us for karaoke every Friday and Saturday night. Like and follow us on Facebook to see our daily specials. Uncle Buck's, located on Church Street, Ottumwa, next to Yesway.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Ottumwa High football on KBIZ and on the live video stream, Bulldogs on the Road at Waukee Northwest. Jason Van Arkel with you tonight. Annie Argo, the on-site video producer, got me back on the air and is currently in search of a cup of hot chocolate. Kyle Smith in the warmth of the KBIZ studios, handling the radio side of the broadcast tonight. Time now to check tonight's starting lineups. First for the Ottumwa offense. The offensive line, knock on wood, cross your fingers, has stayed fairly healthy this season. The left tackle, John Harden, 6'3", 240, a senior. The left guard, Braden Larkin, 5'10", 260, a junior. The center, Brian Coulter, 6'2", 255, a junior. The right guard, Roman Lauk, 6'1", 285, a senior. The right tackle, Matt Payne, 6'3", 215, a senior. Quarterback, Matt Mitchell, 5'10", 160-pound junior. 23 of 45 for 524 yards, 6 touchdowns, 4 picks. And they're starting the national anthem, and we'll just bring it to you here on the broadcast. We'll try to. Thank you. Hopefully some of that came through, at least as you may be aware if you're watching the live video stream. We are in the east side press box and on the visitor side of the field. And the Northwest Marching Band, call themselves the Royal Brigade, they are facing away from us and playing to the home stand. So we tried to bring you the audio of the national anthem there. Hopefully you were able to pick that up. At any rate, we were telling you about how Matt Mitchell, the Atomo starting quarterback, is 23 of 45, 524 yards, 6 touchdowns, 4 interceptions, also 3 rushing touchdowns for him. The running backs, the depth chart we received said the two halfbacks would be Brandon Flattery, 5'11", 160, a sophomore, and Kobe Chantalavon, 5'8", 165, a junior. Could see Brandon Heminger back in his starting spot, 5'9", 165, a junior. We'll see if he's out there instead of Flattery. Those two have shared time there this season. Heminger's been out for a few weeks, but should be back in action tonight, whether he starts or not. The fullback, Cam Maneri, 5'10", 205, a junior. Leading rusher for Atomo, 432 yards, 2 touchdowns. Starting tight end tonight, Parker Derby, 6'1", 170, a junior. The starting wide receiver, Javen Rominger, 6'1", 175, a senior. 14 catches, 283 yards, and 3 touchdowns. Second wide receiver tonight will be Trey Brown, 6'4", 215, a junior. And Trey still looking for his first catch of the season. Chance Egbert had been that number two receiver, but he suffered what we believe is a separated shoulder, and he's out tonight and may not return this season. Staying with offense, let's look at Waukee Northwest. Their offensive line, left tackle, Malcolm Mutai, 6'4", 255, a senior. The left guard, Nick Macbeth, 6'1", 240, a junior. The center, Cole McIntyre, 6'0", 205, a senior. The right guard, Grayson Beattie, 6'0", 230, a sophomore. The right tackle, Landon Kennan, 6'5", 235, a senior. The quarterback, we talked about him earlier in the pregame show, Sam Johnson, 5'11", 170-pound senior. 920 passing yards, 8 touchdowns, 9 interceptions, 500 rushing yards, and 7 touchdowns. The starting running back is Ryan Woodruff, a 5'10", 180-pound sophomore. 195 rushing yards and 2 touchdowns, also 52 receiving yards and a score. Three wide receiver set, Will Retz, 6'2", 185, a senior, 14 catches, 210 yards and a touchdown. Caleb James, 6 feet, 190-pound junior, 7 catches, 67 yards. And their leading receiver, Maverick Inman, 6'1", 165, a junior, 27 catches, 466 yards, and 6 touchdowns. The tight end is Gavin Schaller, 6'2", 190, a junior, mostly a blocker, just 1 catch for 4 yards. Let's take a look at the defenses now. Actually, tell you what, we still got about 7 minutes until we kick off tonight, so let's take a 3-minute timeout, come back, and get the starting defenses on the Atomo Radio Sports Network.
All roads lead to the new home of the realtors you've come to trust in our community, Bridge City Realty. Whether you're buying or selling property, contact our qualified staff of experienced, professional salespeople at our offices, now located next door to Walgreens. We're right in the heart of Atumwa at 301 West 4th, so stop by or call our new office line at 684-1234. Bridge City Realty, Southeast Iowa's number one real estate agency.
Hi, I'm Jackie King, owner of TSD Embroidery, the Stitch Doctor. I just want to thank our customers, as I know you have options. My staff and I truly appreciate your business. Not only are you supporting a locally owned business, you are supporting 3 different families, putting clothes on their children, paying bills, food on the table, and helping them reach their personal dreams. Shopping local truly means more than what people think. If you haven't stopped into the Stitch Doctor, I personally invite you. TSD Embroidery, the Stitch Doctor, 115 East Main Street, downtown Atumwa. Thank you for shopping local.
Most of us realize what this sound means. It means your vehicle needs repairs. This is David Roland, owner of Resurrections Paint and Body, and we can repair and put your vehicle back together looking good as new. We are located in the Old Covenant Paint and Body Building on Richmond Avenue. We do collision, dent repair, vehicle restoration, in addition to liquid spray wraps and more. Stop by our shop at 504 Richmond Avenue in Atomo for a free estimate. Choose Resurrections Paint and Body for all your auto body and painting needs.
Why do people love bench warmers? It starts with the best wings. Never frozen with 22 different wing sauces. Or you can enjoy our loaded menu that includes tasty sandwiches, daily homemade soups, daily specials, appetizers, pizza complete with wonderful service. Benchwarmers' delicious food, the best wings, and fun atmosphere makes it a wonderful place to enjoy with family, coworkers, and friends. Benchwarmers, the area's go-to eating destination in Atumwa.
It's time to choose the credit union with a new perspective. At Meridian Credit Union, we don't just see member profiles. We see people. People with goals. People who want to save more. People that we can help. That's why we offer financial services convenient to you. Great loan rates, online banking with bill pay, mobile banking, and credit cards. Join the many satisfied Meridian members today. See how our perspective can help you.
Meridian Credit Union, where it feels like home.
A lot of things in this world just don't make sense. Like why we drive on a parkway, but park in a driveway? It's just not logical. And when it comes to something as important as your vehicle, you need things to make sense. You can rely on Jonathan and the crew at Vice Transmission on Madison Avenue in Ottumwa. They're the logical choice for transmissions, but they also do brakes, tune-ups, mechanical repair, and more. The next time you need maintenance, transmission, or auto repairs done, contact Vice Transmission. They are more than a transmission shop.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Ottumwa High football on KBIZ and on the live video stream just a few minutes away from the opening kickoff between Ottumwa and number 8 Waukee Northwest. Bulldogs on the road tonight. Time to check the starting lineups for both defenses. For the Bulldogs in their 4-3. At one defensive end, Matt Payne, 6'3", 215, a senior. The other defensive end, Trey Brown, 6'4", 215, a junior. Defensive tackle, Dylan Forney, 5'11", 265, a junior. The nose guard, Ezekiel Payton, 5'11", 250, a sophomore. The linebackers, Parker Derby, 6'1", 170, a junior. Cam Maneri, 5'10", 205, a junior. Tyler Schaus, 5'9", 160, a sophomore. In the secondary, the cornerbacks, Caden Hubble, 6 feet, 155, a senior. Kobe Chan Talavon, 5'8", 165, a junior. The safeties, Brandon Flattery, 5'11", 160, a sophomore. And Joe Gravy, 6'0", 160, a junior. As for the defense for Waukee Northwest, also a four-man front. What they call the strong defensive end, Jack Vineyard, 6'4", 215, a junior. The weak side defensive end, Hunter Smith, 6'2", 200, a senior. Defensive tackle, Austin Stansberry, 5'10", 240, a junior. The nose guard, Henry Kennedy, 6'2", 210, a senior. The linebackers, middle linebacker, Chase Lamb, 6'3", 215, a senior. The weak side linebacker, Harry Linen, 6'1", 200, a senior. And then the third linebacker spot is kind of a hybrid linebacker safety. They designated on the depth chart with a dollar sign, Matt Lindholm, 6'1", 180, a senior. The cornerbacks for Northwest, Nathan Stout, 5'11", 150, a senior. Carter Blakely, 6 feet, 160, a junior. The strong safety, Andrew Eastman, 6'1", 170, a junior. The free safety, Austin Ort, 5'11", 175, a senior. Ottumwa has come out to their sideline. The lights are flashing on and off here at Northwest. And the Wolves of Waukee Northwest High School run down the tunnel to the field, through the tunnel formed by the band and cheerleaders, and take the field. The Bulldogs in their road white jerseys, red lettering, red numbers, red pants with a white stripe, white helmets with the red stripe and the red Ottumwa O. Waukee Northwest has black jerseys, white numbers, blue and white striping. They have white pants with blue vertical stripes. The helmets are white with a double blue stripe down the middle, and the Northwest Wolves logo on the side. I've been telling people since we got here, this is one of the, obviously it's a new stadium, only 3 years old, and it's a very nice stadium. This is better than some FCS college programs have for their stadium. It's comparable to what we've seen at West Des Moines Valley, what we've seen at Johnston. Artificial turf field. Got the big blue, white, and silver Wolves logo in the middle of the field. The end zones are blue with no writing in them. Multi-purpose field, of course. They've got black lines for when they have soccer here in the spring. We're awaiting the ceremonial coin toss. I'm assuming, like most games, this was done in advance. We actually were able, before we went on the air last week at Ames, we actually were able to watch it. Didn't see it tonight. Looking across the way at Waukee's captains, Landon Kennan, their right tackle, is one of them. Hunter Smith, one of their defensive ends. Sam Johnson, their quarterback.
varsity football team.
Austin Ort, the free safety. And the fifth player's got his arms over his number. Ottumwa's captains, John Harden, Caminary, Joe Gravy, and Roman Laux, I believe, the four that will head out for OHS for the coin toss. The tunnel for Waukee Northwest was formed in part by players in their youth football program, and quite honestly, there are a ton of players in that program. They're still trying to get them off the field and up into the stands. Here come the captains. Okay, so just the four captains. The fifth player who was standing there did not come out for the toss for Northwest. So, the captains meet at midfield. Ottumwa, as a visitor, will call the coin toss. And I don't know if they did this before or not, but they do it live here. And I believe Northwest won the toss. So they're going to have the wind at their backs in the opening quarter. And now they're doing the announcement for the honorary captain tonight. Tom Kapatich, of course, the most successful head coach in Ottumwa High football history. Father of current Waukee Northwest head coach Corey Kapatich. And Tom coaching the Northwest freshman now. And of course, he has the field down at Schaefer Stadium named after him. I see him down there right now facing the Northwest stands. It'd be nice if he'd turn and give a wave to the Ottumwa faithful. The student section for Northwest looks like they sit them right on the 50-yard line across the way. Many of them are in pink tonight. It is October, Breast Cancer Awareness Month, so a lot of pink will be worn at football stadiums all this month. And a nice hand from both sides for the legendary Tom Kapatich, tonight's honorary captain.
Captain is Claire Ort. She's a sixth grader at Waukee Middle School.
And as we mentioned earlier in the pregame show, second time this year that we faced an opposing head coach who's an Ottumwa grad. Of course, Adam Goodman coaching Marshalltown now. Bulldogs and Marshalltown played a couple weeks ago, and Bulldogs and Wolves tonight. So Ottumwa's going to get the ball, and here at Waukee Northwest, the referee has a microphone. That's going to make figuring penalties out a lot easier, especially since we're going to be looking at the back of the referee when he signals those penalties, but we'll be able to hear him. Let's check the game time weather conditions for you. This will kick off just a few minutes past 7. 51 degrees under partly cloudy skies. It's actually starting to clear overhead. And we've got a northwest wind at 15 miles an hour and probably some gusts higher than that. And that'll be mostly at the back of Northwest here in the first quarter. Tanner Philpott is the kickoff specialist for Northwest, a senior. He'll tee it up just to the right of the center of the 40-yard line. Kicking right to left. Ottumwa's going to move left to right as we look at it here in the opening half. Kobe Chantalavon, Javen Rominger back deep for OHS. Philpott, a left-footed kicker, and we're ready to go. The senior approaches the football. Foot to leather underway. Kind of a sidewinder kick that's going to sail on one hop into the end zone for a touchback over on the far side. So Ottumwa will start from its own 20-yard line, first down and 10. And out comes the Bulldog offense with Matt Mitchell at the helm. Mitchell's accounted for 9 touchdowns this year, 6 through the air, 3 rushing. Going to be hard to throw the ball tonight, especially into the wind. 2 wideout formation to start. Javen Rominger's wide left and Trey Brown wide right. Might see more of that with Braylon Griffith's normal starting tight end out tonight. Double wing formation. Wingback goes in motion, and the give is to Cam Maneri, and he is driven backwards.
Cameron Maneri, the running back for Ottumwa.
Believe he only got to the line of scrimmage, so no gain on the play. Second down and 10.
Assisted by number 44, Jack Vineyard. No
game? Milwaukee Northwest is a taller team, certainly. Everybody seemingly over 6 feet tall. Second down and 10, same formation. Motioning is Flattery, and the snap was fumbled. Did Northwest get on it? Yes, they did. Boy, fumbled snaps have been a problem all year long for Ottumwa, and it happens on the second play of the game. Harry Linen recovers, and Northwest is in business. First down and 10 at the Ottumwa 22-yard line. Well, Ottumwa had this issue last week. Ames started five of its first seven drives in Ottumwa territory. First down 10, back to pass, rolling right as Johnson throws it out to the right. It is caught on the sideline and going out of bounds near the first down marker. Maverick Inman, their leading receiver. Milwaukee going no huddle. Gain of 9. Second down and 1. Shotgun snap back to Johnson. Quarterback keeper left side. Bounces it to the outside, to the 10, to the 5, and he'll walk in untouched for the touchdown. 13-yard touchdown run for Sam Johnson. And after the fumble, the Wolves only need two plays to put it in the end zone. Tough one for Tyler Schaus there. They faked the handoff to the right. It was a quarterback keeper left. Ottumwa's got to know the quarterback keepers are coming. Teams have been running them all year. But Tyler Schaus was the only one who stayed home, and he had to cover horizontally about 20 yards and just in that one-on-one situation. Northwest lines up with everybody split out as if they're going to go for two. Then they'll bring it back in to kick the extra point. Aiden Gukfa is the kicker. 22 of 23 on PATs. Good snap, good hold, kick up, kick good. 7-0, back in 1 minute on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
What can be better than getting two things under one roof? Visit us at the Cole Palace Cafe and the Candy Caboose, located at 226 West Main Street in Ottumwa. Try something from our fresh, made-in-house menu of soups, sides, sandwiches, and more. Short on time? Call in an order to go. Walk right down the hall and get your sweet tooth fixed at the Candy Caboose. Delicious old-school candy. Your purchase helps our neighbors with disabilities learn valuable job skills. Visit us at the Cole Palace Cafe and Candy Caboose.
Birthdays, ladies' night out, bachelor or bachelorette party, sports team, no matter what your special event or sport, at Graphics Masters, we can make you stand out. We offer custom apparel, t-shirts, sweatshirts, koozies, and more. We even make custom signage for your event. It's all here under one roof. We even offer auto detailing as well. Like Graphics Masters on Facebook to see some of our quality work, or stop into the shop located on Albee Road across from the BP. Graphics Masters, we print your words.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
11-12 remaining first quarter. Milwaukee Northwest 7, Ottumwa nothing. After the Bulldog fumble, Northwest went 22 yards in two plays. Sam Johnson, a 13-yard touchdown run. Ensuing kickoff went into the end zone for a touchback, and again, Ottumwa starts first and 10 at its own 20. Trey Brown wide right, Javen Rominger wide left, Mitchell under center, wing backs either side. And option play, Mitchell's got a hole over to the right side. He's out across the 25 to the 26. And that'll be about a 7-yard gain for Mitchell, second down and 3. A little bit of misdirection that time as the wing back on the right side, that was Flattery, started in motion then came back to the right. So Flattery right, Chantalavon left. Flattery motions, now comes back, and Mitchell keeps out, pitches out Chantalavon, and didn't have a lot of room there as Northwest sniffed that out. That might have lost a yard. Third down and 4. The Northwest defense, I mentioned in the first series, they're tall. They're not very big, not muscular, but they are fast. Third down and 4 for Ottumwa from its own 26. 10:15 left, opening quarter. Dogs down 7-0. Same formation. Mitchell under center. Chantalavon motions, comes back. Option left, and it's knocked loose. It's going to be picked up and run back into the end zone. Yes, for a touchdown.
Northwest.
Matt Lindholm the linebacker picked up the fumble. I didn't catch who hit Matt Mitchell trying to run the option play to the left side.
Fumble was caused by Harry Light at number 11.
So it's almost fumbled twice, and they're suddenly down two scores. Didn't quite catch for somebody for Atumwa there. Nearly was able to tackle Lindholm before he got in. It was great hustle, but he was able to dive just over the goal line. Northwest with a player coming on late here for the extra point try. Good snap, good hold, kick up, kick good. 14-0 back in a minute on the Atumwa Radio Sports Network.
Seasons change. Our priorities change. Your financial needs change. But there's one thing that remains consistent. Our dedication to making your financial life easier. Together. So let's get to know each other. Because together is better.
Insane Motors on Madison Avenue in Atumwa is a motorcycle and ATV store offering reasonable prices on parts and accessories. Specializing in V-twins, but also all makes and models of motorcycles, ATVs, and side-by-sides. A great gift idea, no matter the occasion, for the rider in your life. Stop in, call to order, and they can drop ship nearly anywhere. Call and speak with Alan for all your questions, or to get your repairs scheduled. Insane Motors, where it's all about the ride.
You're watching your Atumwa Bulldogs on the Atumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Ten 10-1 remaining in the first quarter. Waukee Northwest 14, Atumwa nothing. Bulldogs have fumbled it away on both of their first two drives. The second fumble was returned all the way for a touchdown, about 20 yards by Matt Lindell. And now Atumwa in a two-score hole early against the number 8 team in the Class 5A RPI rankings. Mitchell under center, Chantalovon motions, and it's a give to Caminari, and he finds a bit of a seam up the middle, 4 yards out to the 24, and it's second down and 6. Austin Stansberry credited with that stop. Second down and 6.
Second and 6 for the Bulldogs.
Right now, if you're at Tumwa, you're just hoping to get a first down, sustain possession, not turn it over. Chantalovon motions. Mitchell keeps it, and he's got room. Steps aside a man, 35, trying to get outside, and he's hit down at the 39, nearly the 40-yard line, and a late flag comes in as well. Flag came from the side, and I think it's a sideline warning on a Tumwa. So.
Number 6, Matt Lindholm, number 25 on that tackle.
I think the side judge might have bumped into one of the Atumwa assistant coaches there. But Mitchell, after faking the handoff, just kept it right behind Maneri up the middle. And he got 16 yards out to the 40. And Atumwa has its first down of the night. First and 10 at their 40. Ball on the right hash. Rominger wide right. Brown wide left. Flattery motions comes back. Mitchell back to pass. Deep down the middle for Rominger. And he bubbles and he makes the catch. Javen Rominger brings it in as he's brought to the ground at the 35-yard line. And the Dogs are on the move. The tackle made by the corner, Carter Blakely. They'll mark it at the 34-yard line. Gain of 26. First and 10 Bulldogs. First snap in opponent's territory tonight. 8:52 and counting first quarter. Flattery motions comes back. Option play, pitch it right. Chantalovon's got room to the 35, to the 30. Puts his head down, plows his way down near the 25. That'll be a gain of 8 or 9. And second and short coming up as the Bulldogs finding some rhythm now on offense. Marked at the 25, a gain of 9 for Kobe Chantalovon. Does Atumwa get aggressive here, or do they just try to pick up the first and keep moving the chains? Rominger wide left. Brown wide right. Flattery on the right. Chantalovon on the left on the wings. Flattery motions. It's an option, and Mitchell keeping it. Did he get the first down? No, he stopped at the line of scrimmage. And it's third and 1. Well, Ottumwa thought maybe they could fake the plunge to Maneri with the yard to go on second down and find the room on the outside, but Northwest equal to the task, and now third down and one. Clearly four down territory here, especially going into the wind from the Northwest 25-yard line. Same formation. Flattery Motions comes back. Mitchell keeps it out, pitches out right, and Chantalovon dropped the pitch. He's got a fallback on it, but way back at the 31-yard line, and third and one is going to turn into fourth and seven. And it looked like he had room to run, too, but he didn't secure the pitch. And they'll mark it at the 30. It's a loss of five. Fourth down and six. Tumble quickly to the line. Tolovan motions, now comes back. We saw this a little bit last week, or quite a bit last week against Ames. Mitchell back to the line with six on the play clock. And it's an option left. Pitch it out to Flattery, looking for a seam, and he's hit, and he's dropped at the 30, and Ottumwa turns it over on downs.
Brandon Flattery on the carry, number 22 for the Bulldogs.
Well, Ottumwa had some things going on that drive, but that drop pitch on third down really was the killer, and Northwest takes over with 6:54 to go in the opening quarter, first down and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
First and 10, Northwest.
So Sam Johnson, the quarterback, gets a snap, play action, swings it out right, wide receiver screen, caught to the 30, and dragged down to the 34-yard line is Will Retz.
Number three.
I think that was Flattery over there in on the Trey Brown in on the stop as well. Good read by him from his defensive end spot. Retz gets four on the play, second and six. Ball out to the 34. Three wide left, one to the right. Johnson in the shotgun. Play action out to quarterback keeper. Gets out to the right, breaks a tackle in the backfield. He's got the first down. Or he's close to it anyway. Needed the 40-yard line. Did he get it? Yes, he did. Gain of six. John Harden got over there to make the stop. They nearly had him in the backfield, but he squirmed away. First and 10, Waukee Northwest at the 40. Two wide left, one to the right. Got an H-back in there. Snap to Johnson. And he'll hand off this time and picking his way into the secondary is Caleb James, and a flag comes in at the end of the play. James with a pickup of six pending the flag here. Clock stops, 6:11 to go first quarter. Officials having a discussion here.
First and foul.
And they get a face mask on Ottumwa. So James gets six. And then the 15-yard face mask will move the ball into Ottumwa territory. 15 yards from the end of the run. It'll be first and 10 Northwest at the Ottumwa 39.
It'll be first and 10 Northwest from the Ottumwa 39.
Two wide right, one to the left, tight end on the left side. Now the slot man in motion, and it's going to be a faked end around. Now a pass deep down the middle, caught at the 20 and dragged down to the 14-yard line. Catch made by the tight end Gavin Schaller, only his second catch of the year.
Quarterback Sam Johnson to number 85 for the Bulls. That's Gavin Schaller.
That's a gain of 25.
Result of the play.
And Northwest into the red zone, first and 10 at the Ottumwa 14.
And Northwest has entered the Heidi red zone.
Northwest was in a kind of a tighter formation. Now they split it out, everybody wide. Johnson in an empty backfield now. Gets a stab quarterback keeper looking up the middle, trying to bounce outside. Breaks a tackle. Gets to the 10 and is driven out of bounds by Chantalovon. Boy, it looked to me like Trey Brown was getting held over there on the edge, but no call. Efren Huerta in on that stop as well for Ottumwa.
5-yard gain. Second and five for the Wolves.
Give Johnson five, second and five from the nine. Again, that tight formation And they'll pitch it out wide to James, looking for the edge, and Atumwa sniffs that out pretty well.
Caleb James, the ball carrier.
Tackle on the play. Was that Rominger up from the safety spot?
Manary, number four.
Caminari giving credit on the PA, but I...
Number 19, Alfred Huerta.
I thought maybe Rominger got in there. Well, no, maybe it was... Huerta was over there. It's hard to see on the far side of the field. Johnson only got a yard, third down and four from the eight. Again, this is like a inverted wishbone formation here. And straight handoff left side and into the end zone is a sophomore, Ryan Woodruff, with an eight-yard touchdown run. And Northwest has scored for the third time this quarter.
Number 24, on an eight-yard.
Woodruff with his third rushing touchdown of the season. And Aiden Gukfa on for the extra point, assuming they don't pull the two-point try, and they choose not to. Now awaiting the snap. Good snap, good hold, kick up, kick good. 21-0, back in 1 minute on the Atumwa Radio Sports Network.
A-Plus Services Plumbing and HVAC takes care of your home. A-Plus Services offers multiple services under one roof. They offer residential and commercial installation of plumbing, heating, and air conditioning units in Atumwa, Fairfield, and the surrounding areas. From new construction to replacement of your existing unit, A-Plus Services can help. Ask them about available financing options. Contact A-Plus Services for all your plumbing, heating, and air conditioning installation services. Se habla Español, your authorized local York dealer.
Hi, this is Cassandra Brewer, clerical lead at Mercy One Atumwa Family and Internal Medicine Clinic. If you're looking for a local provider to handle you and your family's healthcare needs, consider Mercy One Atumwa. From pediatrics to geriatrics and everything in between, we are here for you year-round to assist you in your healthcare needs. We also offer our quick care walk-in clinic with no appointment necessary, open Monday through Friday from 7 to 4:30. Mercy One Atumwa Family and Internal Medicine Clinic, your best life, our one purpose. Visit mercyone.org.
We haven't been showing you the kickoff because of it all going into the end zone, but this last kickoff by Northwest was actually short. Chantalavon took it at the 6, tried to go left to right, but only got to the 19-yard line before being taken out of bounds. And Atumwa has it first down and 10 at its own 19. 4:29 to go first quarter. Waukee Northwest leading 21-0. Wideouts either side, wingbacks either side of Matt Mitchell under center. Flattery motions. Give to Maneri. Good room left side. 25-30. Outside of the 35. Turns up to the 40. 45-50. Down the sideline. Boy, that looks like a horse collar tackle from behind as he's thrown out of bounds. Around the Waukee Northwest 40. There doesn't appear to be a flag on the play. That's a... What a... We'll do the math on that in a second, but Atumwa first down and 10. They mark it at the Northwest 41. That's a 40-yard run for Cam Maneri. Now Mitchell will keep it, pitch it out right to Chantalavon, trying to beat a man on the edge, cuts it up inside and got a couple yards. Chantalavon a gain of 2, second down and 8 as he gets it to the Northwest 39.
Lindholm, number 25, in there as well.
Was talking with Coach Goodman before the game.
Second and 8.
Atumwa's offense, except for maybe that Marshalltown game, they've moved the ball pretty well against most teams they've played. It's been hanging on to the ball that's been the bigger issue. First or second down play, Mitchell keeping it, gets outside, but he runs into a defensive back there. Tackle on the play was made by Andrew Eastman, the strong safety. No gain on the play. Quarterback keeper, and it's third down and 8.
Third and 8 now for the Bulldogs.
Bulldogs in Northwest territory for the second time. They were stopped on downs the previous possession. They had second and one and third and one, but then a dropped option pitch left them fourth and six, and they couldn't convert. Now third and eight from the Northwest 39. Gentile on motions. Mitchell back to pass. Rolling out to his right. Throws off his back foot, and it's going to be out of bounds, incomplete. Flattery and Rominger are in the area. Decision time for Ottumwa. Fourth down and eight from the Northwest 39. You hate to punt in plus territory, but this is a tough ask. Ottumwa's going to leave the offense on the field, it would appear, as they'll bring on Parker Derby to play tight end, and I think for the first time we'll see a single wide out. 3 minutes to go, first quarter. Ottumwa down 21-0. Fourth down and eight from the Northwest 39. And inside counter, Chantalovon looking for room, and he spun down. Shy of the first down, he was only able to get it to about the 37-yard line. Stopped on the play by the defensive tackle, Henry Kennedy.
Turnover on downs.
That inside counter, we hadn't seen it yet tonight. That's usually Ottumwa's big yardage running play. Not a bad idea there, but. And really, if that play isn't snuffed out by Kennedy, Chantalovon would have had some room. But Northwest with 2:55 to go in the first quarter, first down and 10 from their own 37. Sam Johnson swings it out right. Caleb James catches it on the run, and he's got a head of steam out across the 45 and into Ottumwa territory before he's tackled by Trey Brown. Caleb James gets it to the Ottumwa 49, a gain of 12. Pardon me, 14. First and 10, Northwest from the Ottumwa 49. Two wide left, one to the right. H-back on the right side. Now the slot man James in motion. They pitch it to him, a short pitch up the middle, huge hole. He's inside the Ottumwa 40, and now a host of white jerseys will get him down at the 37-yard line. That is a forward pass. Johnson took the snap and just pitched it a yard in front of him to James. And it goes for a 12-yard gain. There's a huge hole up and up in the middle, and another first down for the Wolves. Now they've got four players out to the left in a diamond formation. Johnson back to pass, down the middle left side, wide open, caught at the 15-10, 5 touchdown.
Touchdown.
Somehow Ottumwa forgot about Elliott Combe, sophomore wide receiver.
Quarterback Sam Johnson.
With only his second catch of the year, and it goes for a 37-yard touchdown.
Number 83, Elliott Combe.
Three pass plays, and Northwest is into the end zone for the fourth time in the opening quarter. 2:02 still left on the clock. And Northwest stacks everybody left on the PAT, then brings them back in for the traditional attempt. Aiden Gookfoot 3-for-3 so far tonight. Julian Sweeney is the holder. Chase Lamb the snapper. Good snap, good hold. Good kick, 28-0. Back in a minute on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Uh-oh. Looks like it's time to bring your vehicle into Gordy's Auto on Madison Avenue. Let Steve or one of his certified mechanics diagnose your car or truck's problems and get you back on the road. Just because your car started this morning doesn't mean it's not time for a checkup. Let them change the oil or perform other preventative maintenance to keep your vehicle running smooth. Stop in and see Steve at Gordy's on Madison Avenue just before the Rock and Roll Dairy Bar. Call for an appointment and like him on Facebook.
Looking to add value to your property? Looking for a top-rated local business? An easy way to do that is to have a fence installed. This is Jared with Pierce Fence Company. Whether you want a fence to keep your animals safe or a privacy fence to keep others out, Pierce Fence can install many different types of commercial, industrial, or residential fences. At Pierce Fence, we strive for excellence, safety, and quality. Give us a call today and find out why we lead the industry for all your fence projects in Southeast Iowa. You can count on our team here at Pierce Fence Company to get the job done right. Like us on Facebook or visit us at piercefenceco.com.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
The ensuing kickoff taken by Kobe Chantalovon at about the 2, and he runs it back out near the 25-yard line, and that's where Ottumwa will take over. First down and 10, 1:57 to go in the opening quarter. Joaquin Northwest leading 28-0, and it won't be at the 24-25 because they called Northwest for a face mask on the tackle. So that'll give Ottumwa by far its best starting field position all the way out to the 40-yard line. Ottumwa's moved the ball the last two drives. They both ended in Northwest territory on downs. The Northwest scoring drive, three plays, 63 yards, 53 seconds. Sam Johnson to Elliott Cole, a 37-yard touchdown pass. Bulldogs with a tight formation on first down and 10. Quick give to Maneri, and flags fly. Maneri, they had some room to the right side, but a flag from the far side stops the play, and we might have procedure on the Bulldogs here.
Penalty on the play.
Full start offense. Not all the players were set before the snap.
They ruled Ottumwa had not gotten set before the snap. So first and 10 from the 40 becomes first and 15 from the 35.
Result of the penalty is first and 15 now.
The clock did run 3 seconds off. They should reset that, but that never happens in high school football. Someone again will keep the tight formation. They will split Rominger out wide to the right, short side of the field. Mitchell under center. And an option to the right. Now he's looking to a very late pitch to Chantalavon, and that goes nowhere. He's out of bounds at the 30 for a loss of 5. I thought for a moment that Mitchell looked like he wanted to throw the ball downfield, but instead pitched it and just didn't have any room over there when you ran that to the short side. Short side options can work, but the decision making, I think, has to be faster. Second down and 20. Back to the 30-yard line.
5 second and 20.
Minute 20 to go in the opening quarter. Now wide outs either side. Trey Brown on the right. Rominger wide left, wide side of the field. Chantalavon motions. Mitchell on the option. Pitches left to Caden Hubble, and he's hit in the backfield and dropped for a 6-yard loss back to the 24. Maybe they'll let him be at the 25.
Caden Hubble on the carry.
Knifing through to make the stop was Harry Linen. Boy, when he made that pitch, I thought Hubble had some room to run, but Linen came flying in. And it's third down and 25 from the 25. Ottumwa started this drive at the 40, had a false start penalty. They've lost 5 yards on each of the first two downs. To go in the opening quarter. They'll go two wide left, Chantalavon in the slot, or two wide right. Mitchell rolling out to the right under heavy pressure, and he will throw it. It's caught but out of bounds by Trey Brown, and it'll be fourth down. Fourth and 25, and now Ottumwa will have to do the one thing I was hoping they wouldn't have to do this quarter, and they haven't had to do until now, is punt into that wind. Fourth and 25, and it'll be Joel Hallgren to punt. Averaged 29 yards on his punts last week. Josiah DeYoung back to receive. High cut a sidewinder. Young will take it at midfield, a fair catch. That is not a bad punt by Hallgren, and there is an Ottumwa player down in the backfield at the end of that play. That might be Mazen Damerval, who's down. 13 seconds left in the opening quarter, an injury timeout. We're back in 30 seconds on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Hey, do you have free checking that pays you? Kasasa is free checking that pays you with real cash rewards. It's more money in your account every month you qualify. And more freedom to access ATMs anywhere. It's powerful checking for more powerful moments.
Take back banking with Iowa State Bank.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Ottumwa High Football brought to you by Blackhawk Auto Body and Linex of Ottumwa, offering the best in auto body repair, spray and bed liners, and aftermarket truck accessories. Like them on Facebook. By Iowa State Bank and Trust Company in Fairfield and Ottumwa, where it's their mission to help you attain financial success. At Iowa State Bank, they take the time to get to know you and develop a long-term relationship. and by Vice Transmission on Madison Avenue in Ottumwa, a family-owned and operated full-service auto repair shop where you can get tune-ups, oil changes, brakes, tires, engine repair, and transmission service. Mason Damerval was indeed the injured Bulldog. He is able to walk off under his own power, although he's limping, kind of favoring that right leg. Head coach Brian Goodman out to check on him there as he comes off the field. Waukee Northwest, with 13 seconds left in the opening quarter, has first down and 10 from midfield, leading Ottumwa 28-0. Three wide left, one to the right. Sam Johnson in the shotgun. Single back on his left hip. Gets a snap. He's back to pass under quick pressure from Trey Brown. Rolling left, throws on the run. Got a man open, but he missed him. Incomplete at the 25. Trey Brown with the pressure from the backside, forcing Johnson off the spot. And it'll be second down and 10 with 7 seconds left in the first quarter. I think one of the linemen peeled back and blocked Trey Brown. It's close to a crackback block. But no call. Ryan Woodruff, who had a touchdown run on the last drive, or two drives ago for Northwest, is the back here. Northwest, a little late getting set, just 5 on the play clock here. They'll get the snap off. Back to pass, Johnson again. Throws it deep again, and it is caught on a dive down near the 15-yard line by Maverick Inman. With 1 second left, and now time expires, the end of the first quarter. Northwest in the red zone. Bulldogs already trailing 28-0. We're back in 1 minute on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
At Five Hogs Barbecue, our journey began with a group of folks who simply love to barbecue, a path that persists with the belief that our ribs, brisket, pulled pork, and chicken should be just as delightful to order as they are to savor. And as far as we're concerned, it's a journey with no end in sight, except the vision of a barbecue spot that's always striving to do better. Join Five Hogs Barbecue Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8 p.m. in the old Smoke and Bones building on 73rd Street and Agency. Like us on Facebook and message us to cater your next event. Come get you some goodness.
All roads lead to the new home of the realtors you've come to trust in our community, Bridge City Realty. Whether you're buying or selling property, contact our qualified staff of experienced, professional salespeople at our offices, now located next door to Walgreens. We're right in the heart of Ottumwa at 301 West 4th, so stop by or call our new office line at 684-1234. Bridge City Realty, Southeast Iowa's number one real estate agency.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Start of the second quarter, Ottumwa High football on KBIZ and on the live video stream. Bulldogs trailing number 8 Waukee Northwest 28-0, and the Wolves have it first down and 10 at the Ottumwa 16 after the last play of the first quarter. A 34-yard pass from Sam Johnson to Maverick Inman. Northwest has two wide right, one to the left, H-back on the right side. Woodruff, the single running back, on the right hip of Johnson in the shotgun. He's rolling out to the right off the snap. Now wants a throwback left, a screen, and it's open. Caught at the 15 to the 10, 5, touchdown. Boy, Northwest ran the misdirection to perfection. Gavin Schaller, the tight end, his second catch of the game. His first touchdown of the season. And Northwest leads at 34-0, and if they make this extra point, the running clock will be in effect, starting at the 11:52 mark of the second quarter. Aiden Gukfa on for the extra point. Good snap, good hold, kick up, kick good, 35-0. Back in a minute on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
At Line X of Ottumwa, we know your truck is much more than a vehicle to you. Whether you use it for work or play, a Line X spray-applied bedliner is ready for the long haul. Line X provides unmatched protection with a nationwide lifetime warranty. Want more for your truck? Line X carries accessories from WeatherTech, Bach Industry, Truxedo, Truck Gear, Lux, and Luverne Truck Accessories. The right part. Parts and accessories to make your truck, everything is possible at Line X of Ottumwa.
Seasons change. Our priorities change.
your financial needs change. But there's one thing that remains consistent. Our dedication to making your financial life easier together. So let's get to know each other, because together is better.
The kickoff, the first into the win by Northwest tonight. They hit a pop-up kick over to Ottumwa's right side. Matt Payne, one of the up men, went down to his knees to make the catch at the 40-yard line. And so for the second consecutive drive, Ottumwa will start from its own 40.
10 for the Bulldogs from the Ottumwa 40-yard line.
They haven't put the running clock in effect yet, which surprises me a little bit. It is 35-0. And the first down snap, it is Matt Mitchell trying to keep it around the right side after faking a handoff, and he'll get a few yards before dancing out of bounds into the Northwest bench. And see where they mark it. It'll be second down. They only gave him a yard on that. Second down and 9. It's all went down 35-0 here early second quarter. Clock is running, even though he went out of bounds. Running clock in effect now with a 35-point lead for Northwest. If Ottumwa scores and gets it back under 35, we go back to regular timing rules. Mitchell under center, Chantalov on motions, now comes back. It's an option play, pitch it out left, and it is behind Heminger, picked up by Linen for Northwest, and he'll run it into the end zone.
Touchdown, Northwest.
Ottumwa with its third lost fumble, and Northwest with its second defensive touchdown.
So
that scoop and score ruled to be a 31-yard return. Gukfa on for the extra point again. And it's no good, so it's 41-0. Back in a minute on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
The secret is out. You're invited to see the all-new scoring system at Champion Bowl.
The first bowling alley in Iowa to have the new Bowler Entertainment System.
Animated and themed scoring grids and backgrounds.
It keeps score for a variety of game types.
There's classic bowling, of course, as well as Build the Monster, Bowling Hood, Battle of the Lanes, and more.
You can also video chat with any of the staff right from your bowling station.
Come experience the brand new Champion Bowl in Ottumwa,
where bowling is now awesome.
I'm Kyle with Kyle Hobbs Allstate Insurance. Our Allstate office has been serving this community for 25 plus years. In our office, we focus on what matters the most, and that's you as the customer. I have a fully licensed team who focuses on what truly matters in finding you the best insurance coverage to fit your family's ever-changing needs. Not only will we help you explore your options, but we help you explain the details of your policy so that you understand your coverage. Remember, you're in good hands with Kyle Hobbs Allstate.
Allstate Fire and Casualty Insurance Company and Allstate Vehicle and Property Insurance Company and affiliates.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
The ensuing kickoff hangs up in the wind, and a couple of Ottumwa players came running up on it, Rominger and Chantalovon. It ricocheted off one of them back upfield, and Northwest recovers a live ball. And it'll be first and 10 Northwest at the Ottumwa 28.
First and 10 Northwest.
Northwest already up 41-0. Johnson will hand it off to Caleb James, running around the right side, breaks one tackle, hit from behind and brought down. Good pursuit on the play by Ezekiel Payton for Ottumwa.
Ezekiel Payton.
That'll be a gain of 5 down to the 23.
6, 2nd and 4.
Make it 6 down to the 22. 2nd down and 4, Northwest. 2 wide left, 1 to the right. Tight end motions right to left. Another handoff to James up the middle. Ottumwa closes the hole, and Caleb James is a yard or two shy of a first down, I believe. They'll mark it at the 20, so third down and two after a gain of two.
Number 56 for the Bulldogs.
Dylan Forney giving credit for the stop, third down and two.
Third down.
Northwest has two wide right. Tight end left, motions. Now another handoff to James. Big hole left side to the 15, to the 10, and it'll be chopped down right at the 10-yard line where it'll be first and goal. Gain of 10 on the play for Caleb James.
Tackled by Parker Derby.
Parker Derby gets credit for that stop. First and goal, Northwest at the 10. Tight end motions to the right. Hand off to James, cuts back left. He's to the 5, and he's down shy of the goal line, but only by about a yard as he tried to spin his way in. Second and goal from the 1.
Second down.
Another shotgun snap, another handoff to James, and he's hit at the goal line. I don't think he got in. I believe that was Peyton and Ezekiel Peyton and Dylan Forney, the center of that line, made a play that time. That was a crunching hit by Ezekiel Peyton. No gain, still third and goal from the 1. Well, there's a play you can hang your hat on in this tough game so far. Third and goal. Tight end motions again to the right side. There's a snap. And this time James is off right tackle and into the end zone for the touchdown.
Caleb James, number 15, 1 yard touchdown.
So Caleb James, with his 6th rushing touchdown of the season, comes at 7:55 left in the second quarter. And Gukfa on for the extra point. He missed his last one. Kind of hooked it into that brisk northwest wind. Good snap, good hold, kick up, kick good. 48-0. We're back in a minute on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
A lot of things in this world just don't make sense. Like why we drive on a parkway, but park in a driveway? It's just not logical. And when it comes to something as important as your vehicle, you need things to make sense. You can rely on Jonathan and the crew at Vice Transmission on Madison Avenue in Ottumwa. They're the logical choice for transmissions, but they also do brakes, tune-ups, mechanical repair, and more. The next time you need maintenance, transmission, or auto repair is done, contact Vice Transmission. They are more than a transmission shop.
You work hard to build the life you want. Your internet should do the same for you. Get all of your telecommunications needs from Lisco, including the most competitive pricing and highest quality data services. Every home, every business, every step of the way. Serving you from right here in your local hometown communities. Call me, Samantha Knoll, your Lisco sales and account manager, for all of your telecommunications needs. 641-209-5400. That's 209-5400. Or visit us at lisco.com.
Romagard, the ensuing kickoff from the 6 up the right side to the 20 and David driven Parker down. Did he fumble? And he fumbled it. And Northwest has it again.
The tackle was made by Carter.
Ottumwa hasn't even gotten to bring their offense out on the field after the last two kickoffs. They fumbled them both away. Northwest with it. First and 10 from the Ottumwa 21. Sam Johnson, the quarterback, gets a snap, hands it off to Woodruff, and he finds room up the middle off left guard down to the 15. Make it the 14, gain of 7 for Ryan Woodruff. Matt Payne on the stop for OHS. On second down, Johnson again to Woodruff, trying to bounce it outside to the right. Trey Brown met him. Also in on the stop, Cam Maneri, but it's enough for a first down down to the 10.
It's another tackle.
Gain of four. First and goal at the 10 for Northwest. Already leading 48-0. Under 6.5 to go until halftime.
That's Trey Brown on the tackle.
Woodruff again the back. Whistles blow. And a flag. And we're going to get a false start on Northwest here.
False start. Offense number 84.
And then, boy, they announced the number here. Didn't know you announced penalty numbers in high school football. So now it's first and goal from the 15-yard line. They called a false start on the wide receiver, Maverick Inman. Two wide right. Tight end to left. Now he motions across the formation to the right. Snap to Johnson. Hands it to Woodruff running left, trying to bounce outside. Hubble trying to catch him from behind. Gets him down inside the 10. And out of bounds right around the 7-yard line. A gain of 8. Gain of 8 for Woodruff, but a nice tackle, nice pursuit by Caden Hubble there. Hubble doesn't get there. I don't think anybody does. Second and goal. Northwest looking to the sideline for the play call. 5.5 to go until halftime. Northwest have been going at a pretty good pace there. They don't huddle usually, but the play call's coming in slower now with the big lead. Another handoff to Woodruff, trying to find room on the right side. Slips a tackle at the 80s, down inside the 5, and Atoma gets him down at about the 2 or 3-yard line. Third and goal coming up. Third and goal from the 3, so a gain of 4 for Ryan Woodruff.
Gain of 4, third and goal from the Atoma 3.
Northwest now with that inverted wishbone. And it's a handoff to Woodruff coming from that deep spot, and he is into the end zone for another Northwest touchdown.
Ryan Woodruff on a 3-yard touchdown run.
Score comes with 4:42 left in the half. Woodruff, his second rushing touchdown, his fourth of the season. Gukfa again on for the extra point. Kick is good. 55-0. Back in a minute on the Atoma Radio Sports Network.
Hey, do you have free checking that pays you? Like I should. Kasasa is free checking that pays you with real cash rewards. It's more money in your account every month you qualify. And more freedom to access ATMs anywhere. It's powerful checking for more powerful moments.
Take back banking with Iowa State Bank.
Birthdays, ladies' night out, bachelor or bachelorette party, sports team, no matter what your special event or sport, at Graphics Masters, we can make you stand out. We offer custom apparel, t-shirts, sweatshirts, koozies, and more. We even make custom signage for your event. It's all here under one roof. We even offer auto detailing as well. Like Graphics Masters on Facebook to see some of our quality work, or stop into the shop located on Albee Road across from the BP. Graphics Masters, we print your words.
You're watching your Atoma Bulldogs on the Atoma Radio Group Sports Network.
And the ensuing kickoff, it'll be taken by Rominger at the 10. He's trying to get to the left side of the 15. Turns a corner at the 20. He's got to see him. 25, 30, 35, 40 down the left sideline to the 50. And he's going to be run out of bounds by the kicker into Northwest territory. Well blocked by Atoma that time, and Rominger with an explosive kick return all the way to the Northwest 44, and only the kicker, Philpott, saved a touchdown. Bulldogs in Northwest territory to start this drive. First and 10 from the Wolves 44. Atoma needed that. The Bulldogs have turned it over 5 times this half, including fumbling away the previous 2 kickoffs before that one. Rominger in the game, still wide right. Tight end left, wing backs either side of Mitchell. And a handoff to Caminary, spins out of a tackle, fights his way forward, still going across the 40, dragging the pile, and down to the 39-yard line. Caminary looked like he was going to be stopped for no gain, but he broke the tackle, spun off his own blocker there, Parker Derby, who was holding up pretty well. It ends up being a 5-yard run for Maneri. Toughest 5 yards he's had in a while. Second down and 5. 3:20 and counting to go in the half. It's getting a little chillier out there. And it's the inside counter to Chantalovon trying to follow a blocker and got a couple of yards or maybe just a yard. John Harden was leading the way there and Chantalovon trying to follow him, but the black jerseys of the Wolves flowed to the football. Gain of 2 for Chantalovon down to the 37. Third down and 3.
2-yard gain. Third and just under 3 yards to go for the Bulldogs.
Chantalovon will check out. And on third down, Hemminger in motion, and it's an option left. Mitchell pitches it out, and Hemminger bobbles it, and it's recovered by Northwest. That option had room to run, and the ball just bounced right out of Brandon's hands.
Nathan Stout on the fumble.
Nathan Stout recovers it at the Northwest 35. That is Ottumwa's 6th lost fumble of the first half. Clock is under 2 minutes when they snap it here on first down. Johnson will hand it to Caleb James trying to run left. He breaks one tackle, gets away from a couple tacklers. Would have lost yardage, but instead he's out across the 40 to the 41 or 42-yard line. Gain of 7 on what should have been a loss. Second down and 3. Johnson will again hand off to James. Big hole right side to the 50, outside of the 45, 40, and caught from behind and brought down at the 36-yard line by Rominger.
Rominger and Huerta on the stop.
Gain of 22 for Caleb James. He will be replaced in the backfield by Ryan Woodruff. First down and 10 from the Ottumwa 36. And a play action pass, throw it out to left. It's caught by Inman. He gets away to the 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown.
Touchdown, Northwest.
Just a quick hitch route to the left. Inman caught it, shook the defender, and took it the rest of the way for a 36-yard touchdown with 44 seconds left in the half.
Maverick Inman, number 84.
That is Inman's 7th touchdown catch of the season. Gukfa on for another extra point. It's good. 62-0. Back in a minute on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Talking with someone about suicide or suicidal thoughts can be hard, but sometimes it's a necessary conversation to have. If you're concerned about someone and you've noticed a drastic change in behavior, ask the person directly if they are considering suicide. Research shows that asking the question directly helps the suicidal person feel at ease and less alone. For more information, call Southern Iowa Mental Health Center 24 hours a day, 844-430-8520.
For excellence in auto body work and paint jobs, there is only one place to go, R&K Body Pros. They pride themselves on being a local business who puts their customers first. Not only do they do quality work, they do estimates, insurance jobs, and will work with clients on deductibles. If you are in an accident, see R&K Body Pros to get your car back to normal. They work with all insurances, making sure you're happy with your outcome. Excellence is what you can expect when you work with R&K Body Pros at 315 East 2nd Street in downtown Ottumwa.
Watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
44 seconds left in the half. Northwest leading Ottumwa 62-0. Tanner Philpott's kickoff high and deep, and Rominger will take it at about the 4. To the left of the 5, 10, 15, 20, trying to get outside, and he's taken down at about the 23-yard line. Ottumwa will have to hurry if they want to get a snap off before halftime here. Running clock in effect as Ottumwa's down big. Bulldogs won't even have to snap it. They haven't started the play clock yet.
First and 10, Bulldogs.
Ottumwa does have the offense out there, but they don't show any interest, it looks like, in lining up, and that's going to be the first half. Waukee Northwest as good as advertised. They lead Ottumwa 62-0. We'll take 3 minutes and begin the halftime show on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
It's time to choose the credit union with a new perspective. At Meridian Credit Union, we don't just see member profiles. We see people. People with goals. People who want to save more. People that we can help. That's why we offer financial services convenient to you. Great loan rates, online banking with bill pay, mobile banking, and credit cards. Join the many satisfied Meridian members today. See how our perspective can help you.
Meridian Credit Union, where it feels like home.
At Family First Chiropractic, it is our goal to get you and your family as healthy as possible and keep you healthy for the rest of your life. We deliver an elevated level of care for the entire family. We approach healthcare from a holistic view, incorporating multiple chiropractic techniques and physical therapy to ensure that our patients achieve the best results as fast as possible. We believe you deserve the best. A little preventative care now will eliminate pain management in later years. We want our kids to grow and live an active, healthy lifestyle. Get your family checked at Family First Chiropractic.
At Line X of Ottumwa, we know your truck is much more than a vehicle to you. Whether you use it for work or play, a Line X spray-applied bedliner is ready for the long haul. Line X provides unmatched protection with a nationwide lifetime warranty. Want more for your truck? Line X carries accessories from WeatherTech, Bach Industry, Truxedo, Truck Gear, Lux, and Luverne Truck Accessories. The right parts and accessories to make your truck, everything is possible at Line X of Ottumwa.
A-Plus Services Plumbing and HVAC takes care of your home. A-Plus Services offers multiple services under one roof. They offer residential and commercial installation of plumbing, heating, and air conditioning units in Ottumwa, Fairfield, and the surrounding areas. From new construction to replacement of your existing unit, A-Plus Services can help. Ask them about available financing options. Contact A-Plus Services for all your plumbing, heating, and air conditioning installation services. Se habla Español, your authorized local York dealer.
Looking to add value to your property? Looking for a top-rated local business? An easy way to do that is to have a fence installed. This is Jared with Pierce Fence Company. Whether you want a fence to keep your animals safe or a privacy fence to keep others out, Pierce Fence can install many different types of commercial, industrial, or residential fences. At Pierce Fence, we strive for excellence, safety, and quality. Give us a call today and find out why we lead the industry for all your fence projects in Southeast Iowa. You can count on our team here at Pierce Fence Company to get the job done right. Like us on Facebook or visit us at piercefenceco.com.
All roads lead to the new home of the realtors you've come to trust in our community, Bridge City Realty. Whether you're buying or selling property, contact our qualified staff of experienced, professional salespeople at our offices, now located next door to Walgreens. We're right in the heart of Ottumwa at 301 West 4th, so stop by or call our new office line at 684-1234. Bridge City Realty, Southeast Iowa's number one real estate agency.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
We are at halftime. Ottumwa High Football, 1240 AM, 102.7 FM, KBIZ. Live video on the Ottumwa Radio Group Facebook page. All Waukee Northwest at the half. They lead Ottumwa 62-0. Bulldog football brought to you by A-Plus Services, your one call for plumbing, heating, and air conditioning, boiler services, new construction or remodels, financing available. Contact A-Plus Services today. Si habla Español. by Pierce Fence, the only name you need to know for all your residential or commercial fencing projects. Contact them for a free estimate. Like and follow them on Facebook or visit them at PierceFenceCO.com. And by Five Hogs Barbecue, they're just a group of friends who love to barbecue and have a good time while providing the best service and barbecue in Southeast Iowa. Open Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8 in the old Smoke and Bones building on Old Agency Highway. Like them on Facebook. Well, Ottumwa started with the first possession. They fumbled it away on their second play. Waukee Northwest needed two plays to score the first touchdown. Bulldogs' second possession, they fumbled and Northwest returned it for a touchdown. The next two Ottumwa possessions would both end on downs in Waukee Northwest territory. Northwest would respond to both of those by taking it down and scoring their third and fourth touchdowns. The Bulldogs punted it away on their fifth possession. And Northwest took over. The quarter ended during that possession, and then Northwest would score in the first play of the second quarter. So with 11:52 until halftime, it was already 35-0 Wolves. Ottumwa would lose another fumble on its next possession that was returned for a touchdown. The Bulldogs would then fumble away the next two kickoffs, leading to two more Northwest scores. And then on Ottumwa's final possession, they fumbled again, and Northwest would score a touchdown with 44 seconds left in the half. And with the running clock in effect, the half ended after the ensuing kickoff. So you can hear the two issues Ottumwa had, obviously the turnovers being the main one. Six first-half turnovers, two of them directly returned for scores, the other four leading to scores. Six lost fumbles and a half. Not going to get you anywhere. And when Northwest has had the ball, Ottumwa's really had no answer for them defensively, although only two of those touchdown drives started in Northwest territory. Everything else began on Ottumwa's side of the field or at midfield. So 62-0 is the halftime score. It is senior night for Northwest. They've added an extra 5 minutes to the halftime clock, so we're going to have a 15-minute break right here. Radio side, we'll get you Radio Iowa News, Radio Iowa Sports as part of the break, and we'll be back in about 15 minutes to get you ready for the start of the second half on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Why do people love bench warmers? It starts with the best wings. Never frozen with 22 different wing sauces. Or you can enjoy our loaded menu that includes tasty sandwiches, daily homemade soups, daily specials, appetizers, pizza complete with wonderful service. Benchwarmers' delicious food, the best wings, and fun atmosphere makes it a wonderful place to enjoy with family, coworkers, and friends. Benchwarmers, the area's go-to eating destination in Ottumwa.
Seasons change. Our priorities change. Your financial needs change. But there's one thing that remains consistent. Our dedication to making your financial life easier together. So let's get to know each other. Because together is better.
At Five Hogs Barbecue, our journey began with a group of folks who simply loved to barbecue, a path that persists with the belief that our ribs, brisket, pulled pork, and chicken should be just as delightful to order as they are to savor. And as far as we're concerned, it's a journey with no end in sight, except the vision of a barbecue spot that's always striving to do better. Join Five Hogs Barbecue Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8 p.m. in the old Smoke and Bones building on 73rd Street in Agency. Like us on Facebook and message us to cater your next event. Come get you some goodness.
Birthdays, ladies' night out, bachelor or bachelorette party, sports team, no matter what your special event or sport, at Graphics Masters, we can make you stand out. We offer custom apparel, t-shirts, sweatshirts, koozies, and more. We even make custom signage for your event. It's all here under one roof. We even offer auto detailing as well. Like Graphics Masters on Facebook to see some of our quality work or stop into the shop located on Albee Road across from the BP. Graphics Masters, we print your words.
Most of us realize what this sound means. It means your vehicle needs repairs. This is David Rowland, owner of Resurrections Paint and Body, and we can repair and put your vehicle back together looking good as new. We are located in the Old Covenant Paint and Body building on Richmond Avenue. We do collision, dent repair, vehicle restoration, in addition to liquid spray wraps and more. Stop by our shop at 504 Richmond Avenue in Ottumwa for a free estimate. Choose Resurrections Paint and Body for all your auto body and painting needs.
High-speed internet is here, powered by a 100% fiber optic network. Citizens Mutual provides reliable, fiber-to-the-home, high-speed internet to rural Iowa.
My children and my grandchildren, when they come here, they didn't like to come visit very much because they couldn't get on their devices. Well, now they love it because they can have chats with their friends. People don't realize how isolated sometimes people are out in the rural areas. So, yeah, it's awesome.
Visit findmyfiber.mycmtech.com.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Ottumwa High Football, 1240 AM, 102.7 FM, KBIZ, live video on the Ottumwa Radio Group Facebook page. Good evening once again, everybody. Jason Van Arkel with you from Waukee Northwest High School. Annie Argo, the on-site video producer, and Kyle Smith, the radio producer back at the KBIZ studios. Knew it was going to be a tough night for Ottumwa. A lot of it, though, self-inflicted. The Bulldogs are down 62-0. Ottumwa has turned it over six times in the first half. All of them lost fumbles. Two returned for touchdowns. Two more kickoffs fumbled away after Northwest scores. And Ottumwa knew it was going to be a tough fight tonight, but they made it so much harder on themselves. And hopefully in the second half they'll be able to just hang on to the football, put some drives together, and try to play the best football they can over the next 24 minutes and build on that as they get ready for senior night next week when they take on Des Moines East. Got the Ottumwa unofficial halftime stats for you. Not a lot to speak of, but Cam Maneri does have four carries for 49 yards. Matt Mitchell, eight carries for 9 yards. Kobe Chantalabon, seven carries for 4 yards. Brandon Flattery, one carry, no yards. Brandon Heminger, one carry, no yards. And Caden Hubble, one carry that he lost 5 yards on, so 57 rushing yards. Matt Mitchell, one completion to Javen Rominger for 26 yards. That's it for the passing yardage, so 83 total yards for Ottumwa in the first half. We're just about ready to start the second half, even though the Northwest Public Address announcer is still announcing the Northwest Marching Band seniors here on senior night. It's going to be Northwest football to begin the second half. They won the opening toss and deferred.
Mallory Weber is the daughter of Will and Heather Weber.
And I'm trying to figure out how much more time before they actually get ready to kick off. Let's take a 30-second timeout and return on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
It's time to choose the credit union with a new perspective. At Meridian Credit Union, we don't just see member profiles. We see people. People with goals. People who want to save more. People that we can help. That's why we offer financial services convenient to you. Great loan rates, online banking with bill pay, mobile banking, and credit cards. Join the many satisfied Meridian members today. See how our perspective can help you.
Meridian Credit Union, where it feels like home.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Ready to start the second half, Joel Hallgren will kick it off for Ottumwa, back deep for Waukee Northwest. Two deep men, and it's going to bounce and kind of die at the 15, be picked up there on the right side, out across the 20 and the 25, and tackled near the 30-yard line.
Hallgren's kick is carried by Tico
Benta-Walsh. Tico Benta-Walsh on the return. And Northwest will take over first down and 10, already leading 62-0. And Northwest, I think, is going to go to a backup quarterback here. Lincoln Souser, a 5'10", 190-pound senior, is in at quarterback for the Wolves here. He'll take the snap and hand it off, and a tackle made in the backfield by Trey Brown, who came flying off his defensive end spot.
Trey Brown made the tackle.
Benta Walsh, who had the kickoff return, had that carry, but he loses 3 yards back to the 26-yard line. Second down and 13. He'll get another handoff here, and he'll be hit in the backfield again by Trey Brown. Boy, Trey Brown's come out of the locker room on a mission. Loss of two.
Another tackle by Trey Brown. Third and 15.
Back to the 25-yard line. Third down and about 15. The ball just inside the 25. And Northwest in their black jerseys and white pants. Ottumwa in the white jerseys and red pants. Two wide right on third and 15. Snap to Souser, and it's a quick give and around the left side. And almost getting away was Benta Walsh. But the tackle made on the far side by Ottumwa. Trey Brown again credited with that stop. Gain of 4. But it is 4th down and 11. And Waukee Northwest for the first time in a while to bring on the punt unit. Tanner Philpott is their punter. Looks like Chantalavon back deep for Ottumwa. And the punt snap is bobbled, and he's still able to get it off. Kind of a wobbler that's going to land and take a Northwest roll inside the 30 down to the 28-yard line into the wind.
43-yard punt by Aiden Gabriel, number 98.
Call that a 43-yard punt, first down and 10 at Ottumwa. Running clock in effect. That punt was down with 9:24 to go in the quarter. First and 10 Bulldogs from their own 28. Ball in the right hash. Justin Ockenfels is in at fullback now. Single wide out to the right. That's Javen Rominger. Matt Mitchell under center. And it's a give to Ockenfels. Big hole to 35, 40, 45, 50. It'll be tripped up from behind as he falls to about the Northwest 45-yard line. Justin Ockenfels, his first carry of the night, is a big one. They'll mark it at the Northwest 46. Gain of 26 for Ockenfels. That might be his longest run of the season. He had 74 rushing yards on the year coming in. Northwest does have a lot of second stringers in there right now. Mitchell on the inside counter, Chantalavon. And he runs into a wall as he gets inside the 45 to the 44.
Kobe shot to LeBron on the carry.
Gain of 2 for Kobe, second down and 8. Boy, that inside counter has been so good for Ottumwa these last several years. Even when teams know it's coming, but tonight the Bulldogs have not been able to break a big one off that play. They've broken a few big runs tonight on other plays, but not that one. Second down and 8. 7:40 to go, third quarter. Ottumwa down 62-0. I know you don't need the reminder. And Mitchell will give it to Ockenfels, and he slips through a hole, and he's inside. No, he kept it. Mitchell did. And he gets around the left side all the way down to about the 25, make it the 24-yard line. Well, I thought Ockenfels had it. They were still trying to tackle him 7 yards downfield, but Mitchell had it. And he gains 20. First and 10 at Ottumwa at the Northwest 24, left hash. Rominger wide left. Wingbacks are Chantalavon and Flattery. 10 on the play clock. Mitchell looking around, surveying. Now comes under center. Gets a snap. Keeps it right side, finds a hole inside the 20 and is cut down at about the 19-yard line, a gain of 5.
Let's go. Red eight.
Second down and 5 for Ottumwa.
And Dixon Montgomery.
Dixon Montgomery among the Wolves in for the stop.
Second and 5.
Northwest safety out there is limping around. That's Aiden Gukfa, who's also their kicker, and he's kind of signaling to the sideline that he's got a problem, but this play is going to continue. Chantalavon in motion, inside counter to the left side, and getting to the edge is Flattery, and he's brought down inside the 15 down to about the 12-yard line. And that'll be a Bulldog first down, a gain of 7 for Brandon Flattery. And now Gukfa's coming off the field. He probably should have just sat down and stopped the play there. He was limping around pretty badly, but Ottumwa actually ran the play his direction. He didn't make the stop. Northwest kind of fortunate that he wasn't further compromised. First and 10 Ottumwa from the Northwest 12-yard line, left hash. Wide out to the right is Rominger. And it's a give up the middle of the fullback, and that finds a few yards. Cam Maneri back in there for that carry. Give him 4 yards to the 8. Second down and 6.
Eli Dobbs, number 29 on the tackle.
Rominger again goes wide right. Chantalivan, the left wing back. Flattery on the right. Maneri, the fullback. And another give to Maneri, trying to find room left side. Bounces outside to the five, and he's into the end zone for the touchdown. Cam Maneri didn't have room inside, so he bounced it outside. And he'll go 8 yards for his third rushing touchdown of the season. And the Bulldogs get on the board on their first drive of the second half. They split out wide both sides. See if Northwest can cover it. They whistle the ball ready for play. Northwest did get out. The left side would have been open there if Northwest hadn't gotten out there. But now they'll bring it in for Hallgren to attempt the extra point. 4:52 left third quarter. Joe Gravy the snapper, Matt Mitchell the holder. Good snap, good hold, kick up, kick good. 62-7, back in a minute on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
In Searcy, Arkansas, a young man says, "I love you" for the first time, but his girlfriend doesn't quite hear. In Franklin, Tennessee, a boy encounters his first pickle. And in Kyle, Texas, after a mission for tots, cousins realize they're a long way from Kyle, Texas. One day, many people, millions of orders. This is Howie Sonic.
The secret is out. You're invited to see the all-new scoring system at Champion Bowl.
The first bowling alley in Iowa to have the new Bowler Entertainment System.
Animated and themed scoring grids and backgrounds.
It keeps score for a variety of game types.
There's classic bowling, of course, as well as Bill the Monster, Bowling Hood, Battle of the Lanes, and more.
You can also video chat with any of the staff right from your bowling station.
Come experience the brand new Champion Bowl in Ottumwa,
where bowling is now awesome.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Joel Hallgren with the kickoff, end over end, bounces at the 11, up to the 20. Dancing out to the 30-yard line, and then Trey Brown is going to tackle the return man, who is Abel Snay. And he's down at the 32-yard line. That is where the Waukee Northwest Wolves will take over first down and 10.
Bob Reed, Garrels, number 53.
Again, the quarterback is senior Lincoln Souser, who did not have any stats on the season coming into tonight. He's got two wide left. Tico Benta-Walsh is the back again. He'll get the handoff, and he is grabbed at the 30 and down at the 31-yard line, tackled for a loss on the play. That time it's Dylan Forney who gets the tackle for loss. Are they going to give him back to the 32? He didn't get there, but that's where they're going to mark it, so no gain. Second down and 10. The PA announcer credits Maneri on the stop, but that was Dylan Forney who basically hogtied him and did not let him get away. Snap to Souser, again a handoff to Benta Walsh, and again Ottumwa flows the football and gets him down for no gain. Third down and 10, Northwest. You know, the 62 points they scored in the first half, I'm going to guess that their head coach Corey Kapatich is a little embarrassed about putting that number in the first half on his own high school where he graduated from. And clearly, Northwest is content to just hand the ball off here in the second half. Third down and 10. And a hard count, though, is going to get a Ottumwa to jump, and it'll be third and 5. They call Ezekiel Payton for it, but it could have been pretty much anybody on that defensive line. Well, that probably changes the equation. Northwest was probably wrestling with whether or not to throw it on third and 10. Leading 62-7. Now third and 5. They go 3 wide right, 1 to the left, but we'll see if they throw it. Now it's a handoff, and not getting the first down is Benta Walsh again. Souser handed off and faked a throw, but it's somewhat equal to the task. Parker Derby with the stop. At the 40-yard line, it is a gain of 3. But it's fourth down and 2. The offense is staying on the field for Northwest. Although Chantalivan is back as if he's going to receive a punt, and the coaching staff telling him get back up there into the play. Fourth and two. This is probably a run or a hard count. Tumwa flinched but didn't jump. Seven on the play clock as Souser looks back to the bench. And I think the play clock's going to run out. And Northwest took a timeout before it ran out. So first time out of the game brought to you by Marvin Boyer with Shelter Insurance in Atumwa. We're back in 30 seconds on the Atumwa Radio Sports Network.
What can be better than getting two things under one roof? Visit us at the Cole Palace Cafe and the Candy Caboose, located at 226 West Main Street in Atumwa. Try something from our fresh, made-in-house menu of soups, sides, sandwiches, and more. Short on time? Call in an order to go. Walk right down the hall and get your sweet tooth fixed at the Candy Caboose. Delicious old-school candy. Your purchase helps our neighbors with disabilities learn valuable job skills. Visit us at the Cole Palace Cafe and Candy Caboose.
You're watching your Atumwa Bulldogs on the Atumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Well, as they play Country Roads here at Waukee Northwest, the Wolves bring out their punt formation on fourth and two. Phil Pott, the punter, gets the kickoff. Kind of a wobbly kick. Chantalavon up, and he has to let it bounce. He couldn't get to it, and it takes a Northwest bounce inside the 25. Down to the 23. Somebody for Northwest picked it up and ran it into the end zone, but Atumwa never touched that ball. And even if they had, you would not be able to advance a muffed punt. But they're going to mark it at the Atumwa 21. And that's where Atumwa will take over first down and 10. Coming off a 7-play 72-yard touchdown drive on their previous possession that ended with a Caminari 8-yard touchdown run. They mark it at the 22 officially. Rominger wide left on first down and 10. He's the only wide out. Ball on the right hash. Mitchell, option left side, trying to bounce it outside and wasn't there, and Northwest wraps him up for a loss.
Tackle for a loss.
Austin Van Horn credited with that stop. Mitchell loses 2 yards back to the 20. Second down and 12. Trey Brown will come back into the game at wide receiver. Sixteen on the play clock. Two wideouts, two wingbacks. Mitchell option to the right, pitches it out, and there's a big hole. 30, 35, 40. That's Chantilly on midfield to the 45. 2 men in front of him. Cuts back at the 30 and is caught from behind down to the 29-yard line. Kobe Chantilly takes the option pitch and races deep into Northwest territory all the way down to the 29.
Josiah DeYoung made the tackle.
That is a 51-yard run for Kobe Chantalavon. He just accelerated right through that defense, and that will be the final play of the third quarter. 62-7 the score. We're back in a minute on the Atumwa Radio Sports Network.
A-Plus Services Plumbing and HVAC takes care of your home. A-Plus Services offers multiple services under one roof. They offer residential and commercial installation of plumbing, heating, and air conditioning units in Atumwa, Fairfield, and the surrounding areas. From new construction to replacement of your existing unit, A-Plus Services can help. Ask them about available financing options. Contact A-Plus Services for all your plumbing, heating, and air conditioning installation services. Se habla Español, your authorized local York dealer.
Looking to add value to your property? Looking for a top-rated local business? An easy way to do that is to have a fence installed. This is Jared with Pierce Fence Company. Whether you want a fence to keep your animals safe or a privacy fence to keep others out, Pierce Fence can install many different types of commercial, industrial, or residential fences. At Pierce Fence, we strive for excellence, safety, and quality. Give us a call today and find out why we lead the industry for all your fence projects in Southeast Iowa. You can count on our team here at Pierce Fence Company to get the job done right. Like us on Facebook or visit us at piercefenceco.com.
You're watching your Atumwa Bulldogs on the Atumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Woo! Ready for the start of the fourth quarter. Ottumwa has the ball. First down and 10 at the Waukee Northwest 29-yard line. Northwest leading big, of course, 62-7. But the only score in the second half has been Ottumwa so far, and they're on the march again. Wideouts to either side, Brown to the right, Rominger to the left. Chantelov on motions, now comes back. Option play left, pitch it out. Heminger able to bring it in, but he had a bit of a bobble, and he is tackled for a one-yard loss on the play. Abraham Parker will get credit for that stop.
Nice tackle by Abraham Parker, number 90 for the Wolves.
Not the fumbles we saw in the first half, but the little bobble on that pitch. Heminger had to reach up to the shoulder pad to bring it down. That slowed his momentum a bit, and that allowed Parker to catch up and make the tackle. Second down and 11 at the 30. Single wide out to the left is Rominger. Derby in a tight end. Inside counter, and breaking through is Chantelov to the 15, 10, 5, and touchdown. He's hit, but he's already in the end zone. Finally, the inside counter breaks free. Chantelov with his first touchdown of the night. That's his fourth rushing touchdown of the season, a 30-yard scamper, and the Bulldogs strike for the second time in the second half. They spread everybody out wide. Northwest looks like they have it covered, and Ottumwa agrees, so they'll bring it in to allow Hallgren to try the extra point. 11-11 remaining in the game. Good snap, good hold, kick is good. 62-14, back in a minute on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Talking with someone about suicide or suicidal thoughts can be hard, but sometimes it's a necessary conversation to have. If you're concerned about someone and you've noticed a drastic change in behavior, ask the person directly if they are considering suicide. Research shows that asking the question directly helps the suicidal person feel at ease and less alone. For more information, call Southern Iowa Mental Health Center 24 hours a day, 844-430-8520.
Hey, do you have free checking that pays you? Like I should. Kasasa is free checking that pays you with real cash rewards. It's more money in your account every month you qualify. And more freedom to access ATMs anywhere. It's powerful checking for more powerful moments.
Take back banking with Iowa State Bank.
Joel Hallgren's kickoff into the wind is a wobbly one that bounces at the 15, kind of dies, picked up at the 15 to the 20, to the 25-30, found a seam, 35-40 to midfield, and caught from behind and brought down is Abel Sneh. And was that Ockenfels? It might have saved a touchdown there. I think it was. Justin Ockenfels saved a touchdown there as Northwest nearly had their kick return unit provide a score there. As it is, Northwest has it first and 10 at the Ottumwa 38-yard line. First down snap and keeping it around the right side. We've got a different quarterback in there and a big run on the play for Julian Sweeney, who's listed as their backup quarterback, but he is a junior. They were giving Souser, a senior, some playing time in the third quarter. Huerta on the stop for Ottumwa. That's a gain of, I think, 14. Sweeney keeps it again, and this time not nearly as much.
Sweeney, the quarterback on the carry.
Had 14 yards on the first play, but on that first down step, Parker Derby gets him down after a gain of three. Second down and 7. Sweeney's carried the ball now 36 times on the season. He has a couple of rushing touchdowns, so Ottumwa, which has struggled with the opposing quarterbacks running on them this year, trying to find a way to slow down Julian Sweeney. He hands it off this time, and that goes nowhere. Trey Brown again. Trey Brown is piling up the tackles for loss here in the second half. Abel Sneh, who had the big kick return, is stopped for a two-yard loss.
And Trey Brown made the tackle for the Bulldogs.
Also in on that stop for Ottumwa, Barbary Garrels, a 6'3", 210-pound sophomore.
Third and 9 yards to go for Northwest.
Third and 9 for Northwest, 8:53 to go in the game. Wolves have two wide left. Sneh in the backfield with Sweeney. Sweeney gets a snap, play action, keeping it, and he's tackled for no gain and maybe a loss again. Garrels is in on that stop. Well, the Ottumwa defensive line is kind of overwhelming the Northwest second-string offensive line here. That's a loss of one. And it's fourth down and 10, and the offense is staying on the field. You got to watch for a pass now if you're Ottumwa. Sweeney play action. He's back to pass all the time in the world. Deep down the middle, wide open, touchdown.
Touchdown.
Fourth and 10, even when a team is up 62-7, if it's fourth down and 10 in a spot where they're going to go for it, you've got to watch for a pass there. And just right down the middle, uncovered, Maddox Toot for the touchdown. Junior tight end. Extra point is good. 69-7. We're back in 30 seconds on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
A lot of things in this world just don't make sense. Like why we drive on a parkway, but park in a driveway? It's just not logical. And when it comes to something as important as your vehicle, you need things to make sense. You can rely on Jonathan and the crew at Vice Transmission on Madison Avenue in Ottumwa. They're the logical choice for transmissions, but they also do brakes, tune-ups, mechanical repair, and more. The next time you need maintenance, transmission, or auto repairs done, contact Vice Transmission. They are more than a transmission shop.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
The Waukee Northwest scoring drive after the big kick return. Five plays, 38 yards, 3:04 off the clock. Julian Sweeney to Maddox Toot, a 24-yard touchdown pass. Wolves 69, Bulldogs 14, 8:07 to go. High, short kickoff. It's going to take a bounce back towards Northwest, and they're going to recover the live football.
Live ball recovered by Northwest.
Someone was not expecting a short kickoff into the wind. That's a different kicker.
That's number 50.
Aiden Gabrielson, who kicked the extra point with that high, short kickoff. The up man, I'm not sure who it was over there around the 20-yard line, didn't realize the ball had bounced behind him and bounced back towards the Northwest coverage team.
First and 10, Northwest.
And the ball is Northwest at the Ottumwa 22, and that shades what happened in the first half. Sweeney, the quarterback, and handing off. And getting outside, Abel Sneh down to the 15. He stumbles there. Sneh down at the 15 to gain a 7. That was a zone read where Sweeney kept his hands and the ball in the hands of Sneh for a long time and finally let him have it. Second down and 3.
Well, number 2. Second and 2.
There's a snap, and this time it's a keeper. It's a different quarterback, pardon me, and he's hit at the 15 and driven back. Make it the 14. Kevin Totch, a junior quarterback.
Jesus Sanchez
giving credit for the stop. Somehow gave him 2 yards on that play. Third down and 1 from the 13-yard line.
Third and 1.
So Totch, the quarterback. Three wide right, one to the left, pardon me. Totch gets a snap. Fakes a handoff, running left, cuts inside, has a first down inside the 10, and he's tackled down at about the 7-yard line.
Number 17. Tackled by Brandon Flattery, number 22.
Flattery on the stop for a tumble, but it is first and goal. Joaquin Northwest at the Ottumwa 7. 6:38 to go. Totch gets a snap. Hands it off. Snay going left, and he's grabbed by the jersey. Broke that tackle, but the cavalry got there, but then Snay broke through and nearly got into the end zone, reaching the ball out. He's down at the 1, a gain of 6. Rasha Pope credited with that stop, and now it's second goal at the 1, and Northwest going to line up quickly. Totch under center. Got to cover the center there. Looking for the sneak. And no signal yet. And they signal touchdown.
Northwest. Kellen Totch. Number 17.
Kellen Totch with the 1-yard touchdown run. And I hate to be the one to say it. I hate to say it at all, but 4 years after we traveled to Waukee and gave up over 70 points, here at Waukee Northwest, it's happened again. Different kicker again. Caden Bertrand on for the extra point. It's good, and it's Northwest 76 and Ottumwa 14. We're back in 30 seconds on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Get the small-town charm with real-world experience at William Penn University. Located in beautiful Oskaloosa, Iowa, William Penn is the perfect place to pursue your higher education. We offer a diverse selection of majors, including a 4-year nursing degree. And our state-of-the-art facilities offer the latest technology. With small class sizes and affordable tuition, William Penn is a great place to call home. Invest in your future at William Penn. Visit wmpenn.edu today to learn more and enroll.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Number 98.
Aiden Gabrielson will kick it off again. Ottumwa's got to react to a shorter kickoff this time. They're playing up, and it's taken back at the 5-yard line to the 10, to the 15. Cutting back is Chantalov on giving ground, now heading forward again at the 20. Tries to shake a tackler, cannot, and he's down at about the 21-yard line. First down and 10 at Ottumwa. Be under 5.5 to go when this ball is snapped. They give Chantalov on the 22.
Tanner Jackson.
And the ball whistled ready for play with about 5:20 to go. Rashad Pope coming on the field. He'll be a wide out on one side.
First down Bulldogs.
Under center on first down and 10. And it's Joe Gravy now in at quarterback. And they give it quick to the fullback up the middle. I believe that's Ockenfels. And he's stopped for no gain. Second down and 10. Bulldogs had Pope and also Joshua Lee at wide receiver. Now Lee comes out and Parker Derby in at tight end. So Pope, the lone wide receiver, out to the left. Short side of the field on second down and 10. Wing back in motion. And another give up the middle to the fullback. Ockenfels again and stop for a 2-yard gain. Brings up third down and 8. 4 minutes to go. Ottumwa down 76-14. Pope wide left on third down. Ockenfels remains the fullback. Wing back in motion. Gravy will keep it on the option. It's a forward pitch. It's a pass, but it's going to work. Racing down the right side. 50, 45, 40. And finally tackled out of bounds is Tyler Schaus. Down to the 36-yard line. That needs to go in the book as a forward pass. Gravy pitched that forward to Schaus on the option. Fortunately for Otomo, none of their linemen were downfield, and it turns into a huge reception for Tyler Schaus. That's 40 yards. First down and 10. Gravy under center. In motion is Heminger. And they try to give it on the handoff to Ockenfels, and as soon as he got it, he was hitting the backfield.
Tackle for a loss by DeMarco.
Gavin Schaller credited with the stop, I believe. That will be a loss of 2 on the play. Second down and 12, back to the 38. 2:45 and counting in the football game. Joshua Lee is wide right, Rasha Pope wide left. Gravy under center. Schaus in motion. Quick give to Ockenfels. Had a seam initially, but then got wrapped up quickly on the play. Andrew Kilvlin on the stop. Gain of 2, third down and 10.
Davis, number 64 on that tackle as well. Third and 10.
2:09 to go, third down and 10. Joe Gravy, a quarterback again, sends Rasha Pope wide left. Tight end Parker Derby is also on the left side. Schaus in motion. Inside counter to Heminger, trying to cut back inside a block. Makes a man miss. He's inside the 30. He's shy of the first down, but it's certainly four down territory here. Give him 7 yards down to the 28-yard line. Fourth down and 3. And, of course, the Tom was going to go for it here. If they don't get it, it might be the final meaningful snap of the night. Pope is a wide out left side. Fourth and 3. Schaus in motion. And a give to Ockenfels, and that got stuffed. Maybe got a yard, but needed 3. And Ottumwa turns it over on downs. Clock's already under a minute to go, and if the refs take long enough to spot this ball, Northwest doesn't even have to snap it. Although they'd have to delay another 15 seconds.
Northwest takes over, first and 10.
And now a whistle, and Ottumwa takes a timeout here. They were having trouble getting personnel on the field. 29 seconds left. Timeout Ottumwa, brought to you by Marvin Borey with Shelter Insurance in Ottumwa. Back in 30 seconds on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
At Five Hogs Barbecue, our journey began with a group of folks who simply love to barbecue, a path that persists with the belief that our ribs, brisket, pulled pork, and chicken should be just as delightful to order as they are to savor. And as far as we're concerned, it's a journey with no end in sight, except the vision of a barbecue spot that's always striving to do better. Join Five Hogs Barbecue Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8 p.m. in the old Smoke and Bones building on 73rd Street in Agency. Like us on Facebook and message us to cater your next event. Come get you some goodness.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
Well, the officials decided not to take the time for the timeout. They just let Northwest snap it. They took a knee, and the ball game has come to an end. The final, Milwaukee Northwest 76. And Ottumwa 14. Take a 2-minute timeout, come back and wrap it up on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Hi, I'm Jackie King, owner of TSD Embroidery, the Stitch Doctor. I just want to thank our customers, as I know you have options. My staff and I truly appreciate your business. Not only are you supporting a locally owned business, you are supporting 3 different families, putting clothes on their children, paying bills, food on the table, and helping them reach their personal dreams. Shopping local truly means more than what people think. If you haven't stopped into the Stitch Doctor, I personally invite you. TSD Embroidery, the Stitch Doctor, 115 East Main Street, downtown Ottumwa. Thank you for shopping local.
At Line X of Ottumwa, we know your truck is much more than a vehicle to you. Whether you use it for work or play, a Line X spray-applied bedliner is ready for the long haul. Line X provides unmatched protection with a nationwide lifetime warranty. Want more for your truck? Line X carries accessories from WeatherTech, Bach Industry, Truxedo, Truck Gear, Lux, and Luverne Truck Accessories. The right parts and accessories to make your truck your truck. Everything is possible at Line X of Ottumwa.
Hey, nice job clearing the clog.
Thanks.
You know anybody who could repair the water damage in my basement?
Roto-Rooter does that.
Do you guys fix water heaters?
Roto-Rooter does that.
How about a leaky faucet?
We do that.
Disposal repair?
We do that.
I've got to run a few errands, but if you could finish up those pies, that'd be great. Thanks.
And away go troubles down the drain.
Pies? Okay.
All roads lead to the new home of the realtors you've come to trust in our community, Bridge City Realty. Whether you're buying or selling property, contact our qualified staff of experienced, professional salespeople at our offices, now located next door to Walgreens. We're right in the heart of Ottumwa at 301 West 4th, so stop by or call our new office line at 684-1234. Bridge City Realty, Southeast Iowa's number one real estate agency.
You're watching your Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network.
And welcome back one final time to Waukee Northwest, where your Ottumwa football team falls to the Wolves 76-14. Ottumwa did get second half touchdowns from Cam Maneri and Kobe Chantalavon, but the Bulldogs fall to 2-5, while Northwest improves to 5-2. Our next broadcast of Ottumwa High football comes up next Friday night. Bulldogs back at home. It'll be senior night for Ottumwa, where they will take on Des Moines East. Should be a much closer ball game, we would assume. Bulldogs should be able to compete with the Scarlets. And we should be back to our 7:30 kicks. I was convinced after last week's game at Ames that this week's game kicked off at 7:30. I don't know if I misread it or if it changed, but I double-checked this week. We're scheduled for a 7:30 kickoff next Friday night for senior night at Schaefer Stadium. Pre-game at 7 here on 1240 AM, 102.7 FM KBIZ, and on the live video stream on the Ottumwa Radio Group Facebook page. I want to thank all of our sponsors one more time. Meridian Credit Union, Bridge City Realty, Graphics Masters, Blackhawk Auto Body, Iowa State Bank and Trust, Vice Transmission, A-Plus Services, Pierce Fence, Five Hogs Barbecue, William Penn University, Southern Iowa Mental Health Center, Sonic Drive-In, Community First Credit Union, Cole Palace Cafe and Candy Caboose, Benchwarmers, Resurrections Paint and Body, Champion Bowl, Insane Motors, The Stitch Doctor, Roto-Rooter, Family First Chiropractic, Gordy's Auto Repair, Citizens Mutual, Mike's Pizza, Lisco, Mercy One Ottumwa, R&K Body Pros, Kyle Hobbs with Allstate Insurance, Gardner Collier, Uncle Bucks, and Marvin Boyer with Shelter Insurance. A big thank you to Bulldog Head Coach Brian Goodwin for helping us prepare for the broadcast tonight. And a big thank you to both of my producers, Annie Argo, the on-site video producer, and Kyle Smith, the radio producer back at the KBIZ studios. Finally, I'd like to thank you, the fans, for tuning in tonight, because without your support of these broadcasts and of Ottumwa High Athletics, none of this would be possible. So thank you for tuning in to Bulldog Football on 1240 AM, 102.7 FM, KBIZ, and on the live video stream on the Ottumwa Radio Group Facebook page. My name is Jason Van Arkel. I'll talk to you next Friday night. It's senior night for the Bulldogs when they play host to Des Moines East. Until then, good night, everybody.